After the successful second nuclear testing, work on the third nuclear testing starts. Comrades on the testing site resolutely pursue the working styles of 4 firsts and 3 8. The political air is thick in the entire testing area. Read Chairman Mao's books. Obey Chairman Mao's orders. Follow Chairman Mao's principles in doing things, and be a good fighter for Chairman Mao. This becomes the common behavior of all the comrades on the testing ground. They always carry Chairman Mao's works with them and study them everywhere and anytime. They resolutely and thoroughly implement the directives of Vice Chairman Lin Bao on giving prominence to politics and the 5 principles. They study hard and apply their knowledge to their work. Here the cadres and servicemen are exchanging their experiences in the creative study and use of Chairman Mao's works. They realize that Chairman Mao's sayings are honest, most powerful, every sentence contains truth, every sentence is worth 10,000 other sentences, and Mao Tse Tung's thought gets results when applied in any situation. The kitchen comrades also put forth their efforts for this nuclear test. Look at the sandstorm and the howling wind, how turbulent they are, and the skies and earth, how dark they are. But who cares? No matter how great the difficulties are, they cannot be greater than the determination of fighters who are armed with Mao Tse Tung's thought. They, from the beginning to the end, resolutely stay at their fighting posts. Chairman Mao says, the Chinese people are not even afraid of death. How could they be afraid of difficulties? Our comrades, cadres, and fighters, following Chairman Mao's teachings of the spirit of the foolish old man who moved the mountains, are working together intensely to complete great engineering work. Comrades, remembering Chairman Mao's teachings, blend their sky-high revolutionary fervor with their scientific attitude to strictly check all types of instruments and installations. These are the materials and equipment for civilian uses to be tested. They are preparing the different animals for participation in the test. Thank you. The stimulating time, 1600 hours on May 9th, 1966, will soon be here. The nation's first nuclear bomb containing thermo materials explodes successfully. From the time of the successful explosion of our first atomic bomb to the successful explosion of our first thermonuclear bomb, it took us only a little over 1 year. Such great leap forward progress proves that the Chinese people, equipped with Mao Tse Tung's thought, dare to take a road never before taken by their predecessors, dare to scale a peak never before scaled by their predecessors, and are able to equal any miracle done by anyone else. The results of the third nuclear test again prove that the power of our nuclear weapon is tremendous. Nonetheless, it also again proves that with adequate protection, complete defense against nuclear weapons is possible. Look at these two dogs underground. They are much safer than those dogs on the surface. They had only an iron plate coated with lime over them. After the explosion, they are not harmed by the radiation. These chickens even laid eggs after the nuclear explosion. The monkeys in the sheltered headquarters leaped only once when the fierce explosion occurred. There is no damage to the electric lights and electric wires in the sheltered headquarters. The sheltered headquarters is adequate protection against atomic attack. The exposed buildings on the surface are seriously damaged, but the nearby semi-underground buildings are in good condition. The earth, scorched by the explosion, can still nourish plants. The seeds exposed to the explosion can still germinate and grow. Damaged crops can live and even grow luxuriantly. Khrushchev and his revisionists recklessly said that the atomic bomb would destroy all mankind. This is nothing but a devilish lie. They just want to bully the revolutionary people with their nuclear bomb. We proudly receive the wonderful news. Victory belongs to the great, glorious, and correct Chinese Communist Party. Glory belongs to our most beloved Chairman Mao. After the third nuclear test, our government solemnly reiterates that China conducts necessary but restricted nuclear tests to develop nuclear weapons to oppose the nuclear tyranny and nuclear threats of the U.S. imperialists and their cooperators, and to oppose the connivance of the United States and the Soviet Union to monopolize nuclear weapons, to crush the revolutionary struggles of all the oppressed people and oppressed races. At any time or under any circumstance, China will never use the nuclear weapon first. The Chinese people and the Chinese government will, as they always have continuously, unswervingly struggle together with all the peace-loving peoples and nations in the whole world and for the lofty goal of all our prohibition and thorough destruction of all nuclear weapons. The morale of the revolutionary people in the whole world is bolstered by the successful capability of the Chinese people to control nuclear weapons. This punctures the pride of the imperialists, the neo-revisionists, and the reactionary cliques of various nations. For this, we have received numerous felicitations from fraternal parties, friendly countries, government leaders, people's groups, and enlightened personages, congratulating us on our great achievements in the third nuclear test. They cheer fervently because the nuclear weapons in the hands of the Chinese people are ones to be used for the protection of world peace, for inspiring the revolutionary people in the world to struggle against the United States. This is a victory of Mao Tse Tung's thought and the victory of the general line. Shout aloud with fervent emotion. Sing aloud with fervent emotion. We must always remember Chairman Mao's dictum. The atomic bomb is a paper tiger used by the U.S. reactionary cliques to frighten the people. It appears ferocious, but actually it is not. Of course, the atomic bomb is a large-scale mass-killing weapon, but what decides the outcome of a war is not one or two new weapons, but the people.